the biggest lies in real estate. In the modern business world, it is very difficult to know if a deal is fair or not. We would rather say the root of business is all about finding genuine deals, so you have to have a good eye to identify one. The most twisted and fraudulent deals always come out to be in the field of property dealerships and ownership only. It is probably one of the easiest ways to thug people out there who are looking for genuine properties to purchase, and then later sell in their own offers or just use it for themselves. This process is not only applicable to normal properties, but also is very common in real estate properties. Real estate includes each and every element in the entire property, be it the front yard garden, the swimming pool, the trees of the house, and everything you can think of which is included in a particular plot. These real estate properties are sold worth $1 million, and you would be shocked to know that there are always millions of interested clients to purchase these real estate properties right away at hand. Maybe a possible reason for it could be the versatility of these properties, because you could purchase one real estate property and transform the entire thing into another, and then sell it at double the price. Hence, it's a win-win situation for both the seller and the buyer, just have money in your pocket. But you know what they always say? Anything worth so much demand is always the one that disappoints the most. The fraudsters prefer to thug people majorly evenly in this matter, because when a person badly wants a property, he or she could do anything to get a hold of it. Even if not directly thugging people, just for their own profit and the buyer's loss, a lot of people use the help of several lies and myths to sell their real estate. Although it is wrong, it is a very common practice in this property buying and selling business, so no one can say anything about this. As we have told earlier, one must have a good eye to find out the truth and the false deals just to prevent themselves from getting pushed inside a hole dug by themselves. People who are new to entrepreneurship or buying or selling a business not know a lot of things and the entire process of how to have good eyes to find out the genuine deals. So here we present the common lies and myths which people ignore while buying a property themselves. We believe that instead of having a completely white and completely black background behind any case, there's always the entire spectrum between it. That's why not all properties are bad, and not all deals are good, but the little lies and myths in between prevent a lot of people from falling into a trap that always comes in their way to success. One of the most common myths in this entire business relating to real estate is renting an estate property is a bad idea. A lot of people always believe that renting their property is a bad idea, which always puts them at loss. Hence, they always prefer to sell it from the core. But you would be shocked to know that experts have stated that renting a property before selling it completely or paying rent in a property to stay before buying it completely is always a better idea. It keeps both the seller and the buyer on the plus side, and nobody can complain about anything. We know that under influence, a lot of you must be wondering that how is renting better than selling or buying? Well, the reasons might convince you to change your mind. The foremost reason why you should rent a house to someone, or if we look at the situation vice versa, then why you should pay rent to a house before buying it completely, is the involvement of you in your environment. Suppose a person is new to an area and is not sure about living there yet. So this is the time when that person would like to test out living in that area instead of actually spending his entire life savings over a house. Hence, they would obviously be interested in paying the rent and try to live there for a while before they change their mind and buy it completely, or change their mind and leave the house completely. If we see the other way around, then due to the fact that these property prices are soaring up to the sky, not a lot of people are readily available to buy your entire house if you are in the need of immediate money. Hence, renters are always handily available the moment you put your property's advertisement in your neighborhood. So, it's a constant way of payment and earning without much harm to the owners and the buyers. In this way, you are not tying up your money to real estate. Instead, you are finding a constant way of earning through rent, which you are only going to decide for yourself. Now you would rightly think why the experts think renting is a way better idea, right? The second myth, which everybody seems to believe about buying and selling real estate, is that you don't find good deals on the MLS. For those who don't know, MLS stands for Multiple Listing Service. On these websites, you can publicly see which deals and properties are available in your areas and the offer which they present. It is a very common practice to believe that these MLS do not offer good deals and are always a thumbs down. But this is the exact opposite of what the experts in these real estate businesses believe. People often give lame excuses, such as the properties in the MLS list are always public and are available to each and everyone who visits the website, so they are quite exposed to the public eye. But the experts have given the statement that always the best deals are available off the market, and that's a fact you can't deny. As a matter of fact, the source of the property is not even a matter of concern because at the end of the day, you're going to contact the seller anyways. These deals on the MLS are improperly advertised, so often the best deals go unnoticed, and you can find a diamond in a drain. The last myth, and a very common one, is that the more units you have, the more profit you're going to make. Let us make it clear for you. The number of units you own does not account for more profit. While buying and selling a property, the only two things which are the most important are the expenses your property would make in the financial market while you sell it for later, and the amount of cost at which you have purchased the same property for. Suppose you have a 2-unit property worth $300,000 and you make $30,000 profit. Then this deal is far better than someone who has a 10-unit property of $300,000 and makes a profit of $30,000. We hope you have a clear idea of what we are trying to make you understand with respect to the unitary method. In this example, you can clearly see that a person having a lesser unit makes the exact same profit as the man with 10 units. The last and the most important myth that needs to be busted out is people waiting for a crash to buy a property. Well, it is a very common practice for someone to wait for the market to crash down so that they can buy the same property at a lesser price. Do they think that they can time the market themselves and be on the profit side? Well, if you're someone who believes in this myth, then in your favor, we must say that if you are good at timing the market, then you can make a hell and heaven difference, which is all in your hands. But it is also a myth that the market needs to be at the bottom for you to buy a property at a good deal. But a complicated but true theory given by the experts is that a person who waits for the market to crash is exactly the person who won't buy the property while the market is crashed. Because when the market actually crashes, you won't even believe what these people use as their excuses. They go on saying that they won't buy the property right away because they were waiting for the market to crash down a little more so that they could get a little more fair price. We know humans are never satisfied. This brings us to the end of our video. I hope you enjoyed it. Hit like if you did. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss any of our videos in the future. Also, watch the two videos that are on your screen because I'm sure you'll love them. With that, I'll see you in the next video.